it should come to this. We try to warn you all, but oh dear. You may not share our intellect, which might explain your disrespect for all the natural wonders that grow around you.
Hello everyone, this video is a comparison between the 1970s book version and the 2005 movie version of Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy. Now just like any movie that was originally a book, there are many differences between the two. But first, here's a brief summary of the book. Oh, and by the way, what you just heard and you're faintly hearing right now is a shortened version of the theme song of the Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy movie, So Long and Thanks for All the Fish. The Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy is a British comic science fiction novel by Douglas Adams, first published in October of 1979, and yes, there are many different versions of the cover. It's the first in a 5-book series of the same name, but we won't get into that. The book starts out with human Arthur Dent, whose house is about to get demolished to make way for a bypass. While he lies under the bulldozer to try to stop this, his friend Ford Prefect comes to him and tries to warn him about soon-to-come destruction of Earth while confessing that Ford himself is an alien and not from Earth. It turns out that soon-to-come was less than an hour, and ironically, aliens are demolishing Earth to make way for a hyperspace bypass. The two manage to escape by hitching a ride with the aliens just before they destroy Earth, like this. Of course, hitching a ride was against regulations, and they're thrown out into space left to die. Just before they suffocate, they are very improbably rescued by the Heart of Gold, a spaceship that utilizes the infinite improbability drive, which allows them to go anywhere in the universe. There, they meet Ford's two-headed semi-cousin and president of the galaxy, Zaphod Beeblebrox, and a depressed robot, Marvin. They also meet Trillian, a female human, and as a result of Earth's destruction, Arthur and Trillian are the only two remaining humans in the universe. We learn Zaphod is searching for the legendary planet of
Magrathea!
When they get to Magrathea, Arthur is separated from the rest of the group, only to be found by Slart Bartfast.
My name is Slart Bartfast. I said it wasn't important.
He reveals to Arthur that Deep Thought, a very powerful computer, was ordered by mice to calculate the ultimate answer to life, the universe, and everything, which turned out to be
42.
Yes, the number 42. The mice, who are actually hyper-intelligent beings, orders Deep Thought to calculate the ultimate question to life, the universe, and everything, so that the answer makes sense. While Deep Thought explains that it itself is not powerful enough to do that, it can design a computer that is. Slart Bartfast shows Arthur Earth Mark II, an exact copy of Earth that is almost near construction. Slart Bartfast then explains that Earth was not an ordinary planet, but a massive supercomputer designed by Deep Thought to calculate the ultimate question. And 5 minutes, 5 minutes before the ultimate question was done calculating, the aliens had destroyed Earth. The mice now needed the ultimate question, and they realized since Arthur was on Earth right before it was destroyed, he has the question in his brain. And all they have to do is cut Arthur's head open and analyze his brain. Of course, Arthur wants to live, and so he escapes. After Earth Mark II being activated and Arthur being reconciled with his group, they board their spaceship and head for the restaurant at the end of the universe. And that's the book, illustrated using movie graphics. Now for the comparison. As you probably all have noticed, nearly all movie adaptations of books leave out some scenes. Some examples of these are Hunger Games, the Harry Potter series, the Twilight series, the Lord of the Rings series, and many, many more. But in the case of Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy, scenes are not omitted as much. In fact, more scenes are added to the movie. For example, in the movie, Arthur, Ford, Zaphod, and Trillian go to the planet of Viltvotal 6 and meet Zaphod's old rival in the presidential election, Humma Kavula. Humma captures the team and wants them to go to Magrathea to get Humma a special weapon. In return, he will give Zaphod the coordinates for Magrathea, while one of Zaphod's heads are kept as collateral. After this, Trillian is kidnapped by the same aliens that destroyed Earth. The team goes to rescue Trillian at the planet Vogsphere after filling out prisoner release forms, finding out they filled out the wrong form, twice. They rescue her just before she is killed. Now, this entire 20-minute scene in the movie never actually happened in the book. While the planet of Vogsphere is described and mentioned, the characters never go there, and it was said to have been long abandoned. Of course, some minor scenes were cut, and they were one of the funniest scenes in the book, but they were probably cut because of time constraints, and they would have made the movie days long. That was basically the only main change in addition and omission of scenes. The other differences are changes or omission of explaining details that were in the book. For example, one main detail in the movie is that Trillian and Arthur fall in love with each other, while in the book, Trillian has neutral feelings toward Arthur and was never interested in him romantically. Also in the book, Zaphod searches for Magrathea in the hope of acquiring riches that are supposedly on the planet. In the movie, while he does search for Magrathea, he was not interested in money, but in the lasting theme of finding the ultimate question to life, the universe, and everything. In the book, Arthur is completely devastated over the loss of Earth, and all he wants to do is go back to Earth somehow. However, in the movie, although he is sad about the loss of Earth, he changes his mind and chooses to continue exploring the universe with his friends. Other minor changes are that the Heart of Gold is shaped like a running shoe, and Trillian is said to have a vaguely Middle Eastern appearance in the book. In the movie, the Heart of Gold is a spherical shape, and Trillian is a white American played by Zooey Deschanel. That was my review / comparison of The Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy book and movie. Thank you for watching.